Morning all. Out for a ride this morning with Wayne. We're heading out to Glasshouse in the sun. And then I think we'll probably head on out to Mt Mee. Got a DR650, a DRZ400, and the Husky TR. Bit of rain around, but not too bad for the day. And I'll catch up with you when we get to something a bit more interesting.
Just hope the audio is working properly today too. Guess we'll soon find out, eh?
Heading off onto the Woodford Road through Glasshouse Mountains at the moment. The wombats have been hit, unfortunately, by the look of it. Great day for a ride though. There's a lot through here on four-wheel drives, not as much on bikes. I think we'll end up at Mt Mee this afternoon, so see how we end up. Still running road pressures at the moment, so I do need to sort that out. Probably when we get to Woodford. It's only gravel road between here and Woodford, so not a real big need to air down.
Down to 18. So hopefully that'll make it a bit better. It's much better. Really is a beautiful part of the country.
Here through Glasshouse. You've got Wayne leading the way on his DR650, and then his son on his DRZ400.
Yeah, quite probably.
But,
well, it's all part of the fun.
Yeah.
I'm happy just to follow. Like I said, a little bit of a case of blind leading the blind. That's part of the fun. Choose your own adventure. I've not been through this part of Glasshouse, I don't think. This is the way I've never been. I normally go right here, towards Telecom Hill. This is the way I've always wanted to come and never have. Thank you. quite pretty down here. I've never been down here before, even in a four-wheel drive. Where we turn left up there, I always go straight ahead. So apparently this brings us out of Woodford. We're pretty close to it. A little bit of wet clay around, but it's not too bad. Pays to pay attention, eh? I did not see that dip. Bottomed out the front forks. Can't wait till I get the new front forks. So currently on Cove Road, heading into Woodford. Stop, have a drink, have a bite to eat. And then head on to Mt Mee. You'll notice with this Desert HT front tyre is at road pressures on dirt is bloody awful, but as soon as you let it down to 18 psi it grips like there's no tomorrow. And she is a little bit skittish on the wet tarmac this morning, but nothing you can't handle. So I've ordered a Desert HT for the rear. I was hoping to have that on today, but it just didn't turn up in time. Some of you may or may not know, I'm running the tubeless system as well. It's T-U-B-L-I-S-S. And I've got nothing but praise for that. It comes with a rim lock, which these don't come with standard. And just gives so much more protection for the rim because it just holds the tire of the bead. It hasn't caused any handling characteristics that I don't like. It hasn't lost any air. In fact, the tire itself hasn't even been losing any air. Like, if you leave it, when I checked it this morning, it's still at exactly the same pressure that it was when I left it last weekend. If you know anything about spoked rims and tubes, I can't remember the last time I've had that happen. So yeah. So far, two thumbs up for the tubeless system. It'll go on the rear as well when I put the new tyre on. I just don't recommend fitting it to a second-hand tyre or a used tyre. So that's why I haven't put it on there yet. So heading out to Yagla Highway National Park, out towards Mt Mee. Not much water in the creek. how pretty is it through here, eh? Nice little camp spot in here, Archer Camp. Fairly well patronised today. Like a good spot to stop. Back to it after a nice little stop. Stopped, had some morning tea. Took four drives with Wayne and his son Ace. Turns out we actually know a whole heap of people from back in Sydney days. Gotta love getting a face full of dust, not. It's a bit damp up this side. It wasn't damp at the other end. Really pretty down through here. Love when you go to change gears and find neutral. That was a big hit. So I need to re-gear this. Second gear for downhill is just a touch too high. First gear is so slow. I hit a massive rock and lost my vape out, so I had to go back for it.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, you can see.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Fucking fell on the.
Just turn off the water hole.
Yeah, right.
It's not sort of super far that way, but we'll keep going. And
yep. We'll yeah, I can see it on the map there, so.
Yeah, we'll probably regroup around
the gantry. Sweet. Might have a look in a minute when we get to the top of this hill. Still feels like we've got a flat tire. All the red clay too, it's damp. that back tyre look flat? Does that back tyre look flat?
Yours?
Yeah.
No.
No? No? Just feels it.
No.
It's fucking... It's squirming everywhere. Cool. As long as... Yeah, no. As long as it doesn't look flat, then I'll have confidence in it again. Sweet. I do like just cruising around looking at what's here. Shit! Nah! And concentrating on where I'm going.
Do one of a couple of things here. We can go down a track that'll take us out towards Daybro. When we get back out on the road, we sort of loop back around and then we come up sort of A break way.
Yep.
And then from there we can sort of run in there, or we can just go straight towards the lookout because there's a few other tracks just up in around there.
Let's have a look. So where are we? We're at the gantry at the moment. Yeah, right, okay. Yeah, because there's a few tracks in around here too. Like there's Somerset Trail, there's K Break.
Yeah, I think we turned down there. Yeah, that's right, yeah, back there.
Yeah, K Break's back there, so. Yep.
And then follow that down a bit, and then we'll veer off again. That'll take us to the lookout.
Okay.
And that'll take through or take you down towards Daybro or.
Yep. Yeah, that works for me.
Yep. Alright, let's go to the lookout.
Another track I haven't done. Heading off to the Somerset Lookout. Yeah. Well, that's why I asked you about my back tyre, because it's been like.
I meant to get off and check when we got there, and I forgot. And I was just coming looking now, and I thought, oh.
You good? I think I know where I am now. Because I've come up A-brake before, and I think I've stopped here before. And then going one of these ways, we go through a little water crossing, don't we?
Yeah, that way in there.
Yeah.
I don't really remember the water crossing, but...
It's more like a little rock step water crossing creek. Like, it's only that wide.
Yeah, okay. There is like a rock playground in here somewhere. I found it once and then I don't remember where it was.
Yeah. Interesting, the transformation from four-wheel driver to adventure bike rider. Thank you. Good place to learn to drive a Raptor. Second ever. Whoa, baby! Fucking caught on my foot. Can't get my foot out. Fuck yeah. Yeah. Airflow again. But I just decided I wanted to have a little sleep was all. I just got my foot caught under it and I couldn't get it up.
Oh, right.
Yeah, so it just took me a couple of minutes to actually get the thing off my foot.
Yeah.
Yeah, it was right as you took off,
yeah.
That last rut. I just stalled as I was just about to get over it.
Yeah.
And it just stopped momentum and I just went, like it only went over that far, but it just caught my boot under it. So I just...
Hey?
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, I'm 98% sure I've ridden this before, so...
Yeah.
So for those of you that don't know, I've been sort of struggling with a back injury since July 2022. That one got rear-ended on my GS Adventure. So this is only the second proper ride since then. And I've just had to take some more Panadeine for it. It's also the reason why I don't stand up too much. My back just doesn't put up with it. So I've been teaching myself to do most of this stuff sitting down. I know it's not ideal. I'm sort of all the way up. The good thing about the TR is you can get right forward on it. So
I thought I missed what I was looking for. I didn't see any turnals either, except for that one back there.
Yeah, so it takes you back to K-Break.
Which one?
That one back there.
Oh, let's go that way.
Yeah. So if you have a look here. So.
Oh, I can't really see about
me. Yeah, so that's, yeah. So it takes you back to K-Break.
Yep.
And then when you get to the end, if you turn right. But this also joins up.
Yeah, this will take us back to pretty much where we started.
Just let me have a look. Hang on.
Up to A-Break. So I turned in that to see. It's just a change or not,
and it
didn't.
Yeah, so just down here, there's a left-hand turn, so we'll take that, and that'll take us to the same spot.
Alright, okay.
Yep.
Right.
And you can't miss it because it's a T-intersection.
Alright, okay. All
right. Yeah. Back to the dust. So this is K-Break, apparently. So to get back to where we started from, we need to go that way.
Yeah.
If we go that way, this way, it takes us to the Trig station.
To the which station?
To the Trig. No, the Trig.
I don't know where that is. No.
Well,
we'll go this way.
Well, I'm just, because looking at the map, because there's no way, because there's no way that way to get back through to that way, to where we started.
No, but the plan was to sort of
bypass that, come out before the gantry, that way.
So, have a look at the map. I'll show you the map. So you can see where we are. There.
Where we are.
Yeah, where the arrow is.
Oh, here? Yep.
Yep. So that way takes us back to where we were.
Yeah.
But if you look this way, there's nothing to get us back there. Like, this is a loop track.
Yeah.
It brings us back to the top. We'll just have to so we have to sort of have to go that way.
I didn't find the track that I wanted anyway, so...
Yeah, see, if we go right here, then we go left, and that'll bring us back to the top of...
Yeah.
Well, back... So that's the lookout there, that little...
Yep.
So it'll bring us back to the lookout, pretty much.
Oh, if we stayed on that road before turning here, that'll just take us way back past that and come out over here somewhere.
Yeah. Well, we can go back up if you want, or we'll go this way.
Might as well have a look down here.
Yeah, can't hurt. No. Well, can, but that's part of the fun. I'm not gonna lie, some of these are about at my level right now, which is good. It's always good to push yourself a little bit. I don't know how they look on the camera, but they are quite steep, some of these bits. Got a question for you when you're riding twin track and it's significantly higher on one side than the other. Do you prefer the high side or the low side? Put your answers down below. I'd be interested to know. Or do you not even care? Thank you. You all good? Oh! That'll come in handy. I remember making the first one of those back in the 90s. Because we saw one on a US video. Back before anyone else had this sort of idea. Pity we didn't start making them commercially. Did I show you my good little trick? I've got a motorcycle jack on here. See if you can find it.
Yeah, I've seen it earlier.
You saw it?
On your rack.
Yeah.
Yeah, I got one of those in here as well.
Yeah, that's made out of a crutch.
I've seen somebody else do it though.
Yeah.
That's a good idea.
Yeah. Works a treat.
Yeah, I have a model at home, so.
A bit damp through here. Stuck in the rut now. Well, I'm pleased to know that speedo gears are run off the back wheel now. Don't often do 30k an hour sitting still. What's he doing? So you got all that side. So we're back to where we started, pretty much. Well, not where we started, but.
Where do you need to go the way we started? Or can we, that way, yeah.
So that way takes us back to, all the way back to Kilcoy.
Yes. We're going to go that way.
Yeah, because where do you live?
Bray Park.
Bray Park, okay. So
we're going to sort of go that way down A Break and down A Break.
Yep.
Thanks for getting me motivated.
No! Thanks for coming, sorry.
I just thought I'd show you, I did ding and rim earlier. So you can see it there. But, seeing I'm running the, running the tubeless, hasn't lost any air.
Heading back to Woodford. Finished up with Wayne and Ace. They've headed home the other way. They live in Brisbane. I'm on the sunny coast. Good day's ride. I have to have a look and see what I can do about that rim when I get home. Really is pretty through here. Wouldn't mind coming in exploring in here again.